My name is Stephen McGann, and my book is called Flesh and Blood, which is the history of my family as told through seven maladies, seven diseases or afflictions that affected them over the last 150 years, and helped to mould the kind of people we now believe ourselves to be. In chapter 5, it's breathlessness, the malady of breathlessness, and it's autobiographical. It's the story of my childhood, my birth. I was actually born in 1963 at home, and like in Call the Midwife, I was delivered by a midwife who arrived on a bicycle through a snowstorm, a very famous winter called the Big Freeze. And she was in a foul mood, and I think I've been apologising for my life ever since. But I tell in this chapter the story of my onset of serious asthma when I was a child, how the physical, the medical affliction held me back and in a way moulded me into an idea about myself that I was a kind of a weakling. And only later when the asthma cleared did I challenge that. It's also the story of how five kids grew up on the streets of Liverpool in the 60s and how we all had to try and make sense of the people we were in that very feral playground, that feral arena, that environment, and how my sickness, my relative lack of health early on held me back from that. But later on, how understanding my frailties maybe had a more positive effect on the adult I later became. When I was a teenager, my breathlessness recovered from asthma, but I got a different kind of breathlessness. I had a kind of a breakdown when I was 17, and for a while I suffered from agoraphobia. Every time I'd try and walk out of the house, my breath would stop in my lungs. I wouldn't be able to breathe. I'd suffocate. I would have to go back home. And learning to cure myself from that at the time, at the same time I was just beginning to become an actor, is probably one of the seminal parts of my life. And it demonstrated to me that a malady, a sickness, can be the kernel of a great strength in your life if you learn to integrate the frail parts of yourself with the strong parts.